Hey guys, Ultimate Immersion here. Welcome to a Vortex installation guide and our new Skyrim Special Edition mod list update. Vortex is a new mod manager from Nexus Mods, which is still in early development, but from what I experienced is a much better and easier way to install and organize mods with than Nexus Mod Manager. I will split this tutorial in chapters so it is more convenient for you. I will also split this whole video in three parts, so it is faster and easier for me to update in the future. If you're new to modding, please pay attention to every step for guaranteed results. This tutorial is working only for Skyrim Special Edition and not for the 2011 version. Before we begin modding, you will need to check a couple of things. You need to have freshly installed game, and make sure you install it somewhere you have at least 50 GB of free space available, test if newly installed game is working, and start a new game, pass the intro and save. I suggest you use this new game save when you're installing the mods to test your modding progress. Let me remind you, if you used mods before, there's a big chance your old saves won't work anymore. Saved games have some mod data stored in them, which can conflict with new mod list, resulting in a corrupt file or crash. If you tested your fresh installed game and you're already experiencing crashes after the logo, there's an easy fix to that. I had the same issue when I did my fresh install, and the reason for this is the recent error in Bethesda's Creation Club, which should get resolved soon. All you have to do is block the game with Firewall. Just follow these simple steps and your game should work. Open Windows Firewall, Advanced Settings, and under Outbound Rules, create a new rule for each .exe file of Skyrim. Now we will download and install Vortex. Go to the Nexus Mods website, link is in the description. And download the first Vortex installer and install. Now launch the app. And on the first step, you will need to scan your disks for games that are compatible to mod with Vortex. After scanning, select Skyrim Special Edition and click Manage. I'm only showing old Skyrim as an example here, because I already made this step for my Special Edition, so it is important that for this mod list, you have to manage Skyrim Special Edition. If you get any errors, on the top right, that's normal, and we will resolve them in the next step. Go to Manage tab on the left and press Activate on Skyrim Special Edition. Now you need to check your file paths. Head over to Settings and Mods tab, where we will set a convenient path so you can have everything nicely organized and in one place. For this mod list, it is required to have at least 60 GB of free space on your disk, only for your mod pack downloads and extractions, and another 50 GB where you have your game installed, because Vortex will extract downloaded mod pack files and install them to your game folder. So in total, that is around 110 GB. I suggest you use the same custom folder for different games that we will mod with Vortex in the future to have everything in one place. First, create a Vortex folder on a space-free disk, then a subfolder for your game, and within, folders, mods, and downloads. To set up the custom mods folder, click on the folder icon and select the newly created mods folder. Repeat the exact same step in the Downloads tab, only this time select the Downloads folder. Vortex will also need a full read-write control of your game data folder, so in case you don't have this by default, just right-click the data folder in your game folder, go to Properties, Security tab, and if you don't see full control checked, click Edit User and add full control. You can also run Vortex as admin to settle these permissions. Now you need to download and install SKSE for Special Edition. Go to our modlist website, open SKSE website and download the Special Edition build. It is important to download Special Edition build, otherwise your game won't work. It is also very important to know that you will have to redo this step every time Skyrim gets updated. That means, whenever there's an update for your game, you'll have to install a new version of SKSE as well, because SKSE will stop working if the versions don't match. There's also a few day gap between the game update and the SKSE update, so please be patient and check their website every now and then. But don't worry, you can still play the game normally in the meantime, only a few mods like SkyUI won't work as intended. Now that you have downloaded the installer, extract the content and copy data folder, all DLLs and exe to your game folder. With this mod list, you will use SKSE64loader.exe to start your game, unless, like I said before, you need to wait for an SKSE update. In that case, you can use a normal launcher for the time being. Last step is to create a launcher path for your SKSE in Vortex. Go to Dashboard, click three dots under SKSE, Edit, and select SKSE64loader.exe. In the end, set it as make primary, so it will launch SKSE even if you launch the game on the top left corner of Vortex. Now we will begin downloading the mods. This will take you a while since you have to download around 30 GB worth of mods, but you only have to do it once. Before you can download the mod list, we only ask you to subscribe to our channels. We spend months working on these videos, building mod lists, testing and debugging. And this is the only thing we ask you to do in return. Some of you were asking about us having access to your account via API, the answer is we absolutely don't, nor we will ever have. We're using standard Google API only to check if you're subscribed to our YouTube channels, and that's it. A lot of popular websites use the same API to access their features or log in, and it's the Google standard privacy policy that's displayed before the login. Tens of thousands of accounts already used our API with no issues. If you still don't trust this, we totally understand. To download, go to our special edition mod list and begin downloading the mods one by one with Vortex. When you're downloading the mods, make sure you're downloading the same names as listed on our mod list website, alongside with all the patches needed. If some mods get updated, don't worry and install them the same way. In case certain mods get deleted, simply skip them. The mod list should work fine without them too. Alright guys, this is the end of the introduction part. I'll see you in the next video where we'll be installing the mods, because the next video will get the most frequent updates in the future. Thank you so much for watching guys. Please leave a like, subscribe and comment, and if you want to support us on this project, please do so on our website or my Patreon. Link is in the description below. Stay awesome guys, and I'll see you in the next chapter.